Welcome back to my channel OE2 Marchinavi guys. Once again, today's topic is going to be very very important. And before moving to the topic, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please go and subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon, press all to get notification for all my upcoming videos. So today we'll discuss regarding the maritime law. The guys who have interest in the law as well as the shipping, then this sandwich type of course is definitely for you. So there is a two type of course. First thing you have to understand, one is LLM, means Masters in Law. Another is PGD in Maritime Law, means post graduation. But in this video we'll only discuss about LLM, and the next video, maybe today or tomorrow, we'll discuss about the PGD. So now this video will restrict to the LLM. LLM means Masters in Law, I have already told. For this you need to have a law background, means you need to have a LLB degree. Not mandatory that maritime law LLB, any LLB you can pursue this maritime law post graduation or LLM. So I'll not waste your time, I will show you all the things regarding the course fee, course duration, semester subjects, how to fill up the form, the most important, and all the important dates that from first semester to the starting of second semester, all the important dates they have mentioned. That is the best thing I have seen in any website, one of the most build up and fine website I have visited. Actually I was researching about this course and all, so I found the Gujarat Maritime University or GMU. So I will show you each and everything, and please check the description box, you'll find all the links regarding the academic brochure, academic calendar, how to fill up the form. You'll find the link on the description box. But before that, watch the full video, I will show you everything regarding the course. So now let's move to my laptop screen, and there I will show you. So as I have mentioned that today I will only discuss regarding the LLM Maritime Law. So this is the Gujarat Maritime University, what I have found from the internet. So this is the LLM Maritime Law, you can see. So you will learn lot of things from here. You can read by yourself, there is a prospectus and all. You can read that tremendous scope of work for an established law firm which serves big clients and all, everything you can read. Now there is two semester what I have mentioned earlier also, and each semester there are 5 papers. You can read, pause the screen and read, and you can, if you click over this plus button, then you can see the syllabus in a brief format. Okay, so there are 2 semesters. Now we'll talk about the fees. The admission fees is 2000, general security deposit 10,000, one time fees I think 12,000, like lot of fees are there, you can see. So all total it will be around 390,500 rupees. So these are the fees, and for the NRI candidates the fees is little more, you can see that this fees and plus USD $4,000, means this 12 plus 13. So that is for the NRI candidate, but not for Indians. So that is the fees and all I have discussed regarding the LLM in Maritime Law. And now I'll show you how to apply. Here you can see admission is going on, just click over here and choose the option. There is 2 option, PGD means post graduation, and LLM means Master in Law. Post graduation I will show you tomorrow. So for today LLM, just click on LLM. There are 2 options, Maritime Law and International Trade Law. Click on the International Law, then you can select your category, general name you can put, father's name, date of birth, and gender, religion if other. So there are options, if other then you can specify address, city, town, state, PIN, phone number, nationality, fax number if any have, parent email ID, parent phone number, email ID, everything you need to put. Entrance exam you have to clear, this is CLAT examination, and CLAT roll number and CLAT score, everything you have to put. Then graduation and all, year of passing, LLB and grade percentage, year of passing board, and application fees 1000 rupees. Then you need to click all of these boxes and submit, and that is the procedure that you can do your form fill up and all for the LLM Maritime Law. So you can see this is the LLM maritime law, full schedule is there. From 1st September 2020, the induction and the orientation program will be there for 48 days. Then 2nd September, commencement of classes. 7th September, last date, assigning topic, research paper, presenting research, and all are there. You can read by yourself. Then 5th October, mentorship meeting. Mid-semester examination will be there from 28th October to 4th November. This is very systematic. That is why I am showing you, because they have mentioned each and everything. So there will be no haphazard or no hassle when you are going for the course, so you have a brief idea before the joining. Okay, so 25th November, showing the mid semester papers to students, and 20th November 2020 there will be last days of submission research paper, 23rd November 2020 final date of submission of research paper. Everything has been mentioned. You can just pause and read it by yourself. The program's date and the duration is mentioned. You can see all the things I am showing you here. Just pause slowly and you can read. Then there will be preparatory leave, then the end term examination will be there, and then from 22nd of February 2021 there will be commencement of classes for the second semester. And here you can see project research paper should be submitted before 5 p.m. on mentioned date. Penalty reduction of 1 mark per day will be evaluated only for 50% of marks. Attendance will be declared on 10th of every month. So you can find each and everything and aspect regarding the LLM. So I think you have understood. I have shown each and everything regarding the course fee, the form fee, again the how to fill up the form, which exam you have to give, each and everything I have shown you. The exam name is CLAT 2020, that you have to give. From September onwards it will going to start your first semester. So if you have interest, you can go and quickly fill all the forms regarding the LLM maritime law. And again, for a reminder, in the next video I will show you what is the PGD in maritime law. So thank you guys for watching. If you have liked this video, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon, press all to get notification for all my upcoming videos. Thank you guys for watching. See you in my next video. Signing off for the day.